There is an old adage that says, people who seek to become truly educated will possess skills to create successful life paradigms, while others, through the gift of wit, shrewdness, or sheer luck, must ultimately rely on friends and acquaintances in order to somehow make it in the world. This is Dr. Katherine Bankole-Medina, and today's podcast is Reflections on the Bringers of Great Knowledge, the Remarkable Legacy of Early Black Educators. If this saying is true, it is likely that one will undoubtedly run out of friends before one runs out of education. This little trope, along with the motto, study your lessons, certainly resonated among African Americans in the Reconstruction era. During this time, the primary aspiration of blacks as a people was the realization of education. Rivaling only spirituality and the cultivation of the ministry, education was seen as the light that would uplift blacks. The establishment of such educational institutions as Wilberforce, Lincoln, Howard, Hampton, and Fisk universities later, and expressly for the elevation of blacks, were regarded as gateways to a new era. For the largely unlettered people, African Americans had the doorways to the once barred professions. And what made this aspiration noble and significant was that this vision was intended not for the astute and privileged few, but for the entire race of blacks. It was an ethos of shared success. While these times were filled with great hope, they were at the same time fraught with racial malice. For some, black education was still a risk. The very idea threatened the social and political order of the country, particularly in the South. Brave men and women created learning spaces in one-room shacks, churches, anywhere people could gather together and learn. And we're talking about groups of people from kindergarten through adult elders. To be sure, the heroes in the black communities were the preachers, theologists, and skilled tradesmen. But more often than not, the indisputable idols, symbols of success, were the teachers, the educators, the bringers of knowledge. They were the magicians and keepers of the storehouses of learning. They commanded the book to speak, and it did. Often eloquent speakers, teachers used the power of the spoken word to inspire and lead. In the annals of African American history, blacks placed their souls in the balance in order to gain a glimpse of knowledge, which was, after all, a key to the social, political, and even moral uplift of a people. And at a time when the attainment of any measure of intelligence was a crime, luminaries like Frederick Douglass and countless others during the period of slavery were willing offenders. Even those with marginal reading and writing skills were often surpassed those of the community at large. They were able to wield immense power. The bringers of knowledge were also the patrons of dignity and self-respect for people worn down by the vestiges of slavery and the iterations of racism. The history and legacy of black teachers is a remarkable one. To be sure, the motto, "Each one, teach one," liberated untold numbers of blacks, and at the same time demonstrated that to impart education, even and especially to those oppressed, is an important measure of freedom.